Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Vice President of the Committee of the Region, representative of the United Nations, OECD, European Parliament, European Commission, representative of the Bulgarian Presidency of the European Council, Mr. Joachim Boston, President of ENTREPS. It's a pleasure to be here through this video. Unfortunately, I cannot be with you physically. But I think it's very important to discuss what you will be discussing this afternoon, responsible consumption and production at this time where both climate change and sustainable development are so much in the discussions. Climate change is a threat to sustainable development, wrote the IPCC many times, and challenge is really important. We need to reduce emissions to zero on a net basis as soon as possible in the next few decades if you want to keep the warming under the limits mentioned in the Paris Agreement, 2 degrees, and if possible 1.5 degree, which would be very important to reduce impacts on so many people and so many ecosystems. So your work will be very important today. Climate change is caused mostly by the accumulation in the atmosphere of the so-called greenhouse gases, which trap the heat near the surface of the Earth. And most of these greenhouse gases are coming from our production and consumption patterns, because we're using mostly fossil fuels to power the world economy today, and we need to change that completely if we want to get to that zero net emissions target, which is mentioned in the Paris Agreement. To do that, we have to change the way the world develops. We have to really make the development really sustainable. So the relationship between climate change and sustainable development is really intimate. You could see the temperature, the increasing temperature, as a symptom of the fever that the planet has at the moment. And you can see sustainable development, if it's really sustainable, as a way to keep that fever down and to keep the planet inhabitable. The Paris Agreement is a very important framework agreed internationally almost 3 years ago already. But the framework still, to a very large extent, needs to be filled with action that's commensurate with the size of the challenge ahead of us. I mean, to get to zero emissions globally on a net basis in the next few decades requires transformative actions as soon as possible in all countries of the world, and that has only slightly began here and there, but has not happened yet at the appropriate scale. So what will be discussed in Katowice at the end of the year is very important, because the COP24 is supposed to finalize the rule book to implement the Paris Agreement. But what's even more important is the amount of political will available in all regions of the world to go further than the plans that are on the table now, because the plans that are on the table now in the framework of the Paris Agreement do not deliver enough emission reductions to allow for climate protection, the climate protection that was agreed in Paris. Action about climate change needs to take place at many levels. The global level is very important because international coordination is key to minimize costs, exchange technologies, share good ideas and good practices. But of course, the action concretely happens in towns, in cities, in regions, in countries. And they all do that in a framework that is influenced by what is decided at the international level. So it's really a combination of action at the international level, at European level, at the national level, at the regional level, at the local level, up to the individual level, that will deliver potentially what is needed to protect environment and climate for future generations. The question is often asked, what should we do? What can every citizen do? And I think the key thing we need to do is do as if our life depended on the action that we will take or not take in the coming months and years. It's really a question of survival of a significant fraction of humanity, of a very significant fraction of ecosystems, as biodiversity is also affected by climate change. And we should act much more as if we were at war, almost, as if we were running for life. So we need to learn what needs to be done to reduce emissions much more than what has been done now in all sectors, in our buildings, in our transport, in the way we eat, too much meat very often, for example, the way we travel, quite too often by plane, which is highly polluting, for example, or indeed individual cars when we could walk or use public transport. And the combination of action at the individual level, but also at a larger level, is what will deliver what is needed. And of course, the economic world and business have a very important role as well in this, as they produce the products that we use in our daily life. So I hope you'll see good ideas and innovations and also ways to implement the good ideas that exist already, and then climate and environment can be protected much better.